In this case, we have a look at a process of polyamide 6 with 30% glass fibers as a benchmark formulation for engineering compounds. At first, let's have a look at the gravimetric dosing units that are basis of a stable process at torque limitation. At the main feed, we have a flex wall 80 of Brabender for dosing the polymer. Additionally, we dose 0.3% of additives, in this case, an UV stabilizer at the main feed. For the dosing of the glass fibers, we use a flex wall 40 at the second side feeder. Taking a look at the extruder itself, at the beginning of the extruder, we use 3 barrels as a melting section. In this case, we use a harsh melting section to ensure a proper melting of the polymer. The second side feeder is actually used for the dosing of the 30% of glass fibers. After the second side feeder, we have a small incorporation zone where the glass fibers are incorporated as harsh as necessary and as smooth as possible. In this case, it is important not to damage the glass fibers because it has negative influences on the mechanical properties of the product. After the incorporation zone, we have a vacuum port that is used to remove volatiles of the melt. After that, we have a short output zone and go to the die plate, which is in this case 19 times 3.0 millimeters. After the die plate, the strands are taken into a water bath. The time in the water bath has to be very short to ensure a long enough time for the strands to dry at the air. It is important to have a long enough drying time because polyamide degrades by too high moisture levels in the end product. After drying the strands at the air, we use a strand drying unit to ensure a low moisture level of the strands. After that, the strands are put into the strand pelletizer and cut to small granulates. We did this formulation polyamide 6 with 30% glass fibers as an example for engineering compounds and as a benchmark formulation. By the high OD-ID ratio of 1.66 and the high torque density of 15 Newton meters per cubic centimeter, we reach optimized energy input into the product. In this specific example, we reach at a screw speed of 900 RPM, a throughput of 300 kg per hour, and a specific energy input of 0.21 kilowatt hours per kilogram. When increasing the screw speed to 1200 RPM, we can reach throughputs up to 400 kg per hour. Scaled up to a ZSE 60 MAXX, this is a throughput of over 2 tons per hour, what is remarkable.